Now I want to address an email from a viewer named Nick. Hey, Dan, this has got to be unconstitutional. A ballot initiative appeared on the ballot in Columbia County to outlaw the enforcing of state or federal laws that restrict the use or possession of firearms or ammunition. How in the world did this get on the ballot, and can this ever be enforced? Well, we did a little digging on this one, and the Columbia County, they're not the only one who passed something like this. In fact, four counties had it on the ballot: Columbia, Umatilla, Clatsop, and Coos, because supporters basically got enough signatures to get it on the ballot, and voters approved it in Columbia and Umatilla. They're actually called Second Amendment Sanctuary Ordinances, and yeah, they kind of sound like they're modeled after sanctuary cities, but instead of protecting immigrants, they want to protect guns rights. Now, basically, the ordinance says that county officials can't enforce most state, federal, and local firearm regulations, like background checks and gun registration or concealed and open carry laws. If they do enforce them, they will be fined, but there is an exemption for keeping guns away from felons and enforcing gun crimes. Now, whether or not this is legal is kind of honestly unclear. Now, Oregon has a law that gives the legislature authority to regulate guns in the state, meaning for a gun law to change, state lawmakers have to pass it. There's also a supremacy clause in the U.S. Constitution, which means that the county can't overrule federal gun laws. But supporters say this is legal because they're not actually changing any gun laws. They're just changing how those laws are enforced. Kind of interesting little way they worded that there. The ordinance will likely go through what's called, though, a validation hearing in both Columbia and Umatilla County to work out all this legal stuff.